I therefore have taken care to guard against that eventuality. I've written 2 books on the subject, and I'm going to Oxford Union. Dear friends, if you have the moment, read them. You might benefit from them. We had the case for the proposition opened by Mr. Marsh. He was hilarious. he opened his salvo by giving a quotation from the cover of my book, Trotsky's Malevolence. Firstly, as they used to say, in the case of credit cards, credit with credit is due. Thank you very much for the wonderful advertisement that you gave my book. I'm sure there are plenty in the audience who would be interested to inquire further. But that quotation had as much relevance to this debate as that epitomized by the Russian saying, there's a bush in our garden and my uncle is in Kiev. Both may be true, but one has absolutely nothing to do with the other. Yes, I have said that. I own that. I'm very proud to have said that. I'm not ashamed of quoting that very great person who did so much for the international proletariat, Joseph Vissarionovich Stalin. I'm very happy about that. But that quotation had nothing to do with the question whether capitalism can save the world or not. Capitalism, at one stage, played a very historically important and progressive role. It got rid of feudalism, it got rid of rural idiocy, it made it possible for the productive forces to develop, whereby society could produce more than it actually needed. There was a justification for exploitation at one time because humanity did not produce enough by way of a surplus to make it possible for everybody to be able to have a happier life. Capitalism got rid of that position, it increased the productive forces, it created a world market, it made it possible for progress to be made in the last 200 years, which humanity hasn't done throughout its entire existence before. But there's time for everything. Time will come at 11:30, and we must come, go home. We cannot insist on staying in this jail. Capitalism has had its time, and it's time for capitalism to go. Ever since 1825, the productive forces have developed to such an extent that they are out of control of the people who run them. Capitalism has the capacity to produce as though there is no tomorrow. But at the same time, whatever is produced, huge amounts of it must go as a tribute to the owners of the means of production and distribution, which means working people are too poor to buy the things that are produced. And that creates, on a regular basis, crisis of capitalism. Capital does not produce unless and until it can make a soft buck. When you listen to people like Mr. Marshall, they say they run a hedge fund. The average person is deluded into thinking they're running some kind of an environmental project. No, they're not. They're racketeers who are out to exploit and screw anybody around. That's what they are up to. Under capitalism, the means of production cannot be used to produce unless and until they have first been converted into capital. Which means the capitalists must be able to make some money out of that. And if the working people are poor and they cannot buy the product produced by capitalism, then there is a crisis of capitalism. I actually admire the audacity of these people that at a time when financial giants are collapsing, housing market is slumping, the stock market is plunging, and capitalists have to be bailed out by the government, they have the temerity to come and say here, capitalism can save the world and socialism has nothing to offer. About what benefits capitalism brings. Do not talk to me about the freedom of the market. No, I'm not accepting any interruption. Being a Stalinist, I do not like him. You are telling me about the freedom of the market. I know you are students, some of you students even of economics at this august university. And the bourgeois professors are constantly telling you about the freedom of the market. Freedom of the market disappeared about 1890 or the turn of the century. Certainly by the year 1900, the freedom market had disappeared. What you had since then was monopoly. Every day when you realize it or not, you are controlled by a monopoly. You get up in the morning and you go into the bathroom and you look in the mirror that's produced by a monopoly. You come out of the bathroom, you have some cereal that's produced by a monopoly, Procter & Gamble or somebody else. You go to work in the car, are driving a car that's produced by a monopoly. You listen to the radio, you can't do that, I haven't started. That's produced by a monopoly. You come home, no, I'm not accepting any interruption from you. I didn't interrupt you and I'm not accepting interruption from you. You come home, you have some drink which is produced by monopoly. You go to bed, that's produced by monopoly. After 40 years of servitude to capitalism, you drop dead and you are carried in a hearse which probably is run by a monopoly.